lifetime, what has been an event that stood out for you?
For me, it would be 9/11. I remember I was in first grade, sitting at school, and they heard it, so they turned on the TVs. And then at the time, I didn't really know what was going on, but I just knew that the plane crashed into it. And then as time went on and I like grew up and learned about it more, that's when I started to really understand what it was about. Okay, what historical moment do you remember that happened in your lifetime?
You know what, I think one of the bigger ones in my lifetime was when the Berlin Wall fell. That was a big one because it represented, you know, the reunification of Germany and kind of, at least symbolically, was sort of an end to that whole mess that really defined the 20th century, which was, you know, the World War II. So tell me what you think is a major difference between your generation and the generation that came up behind you.
I think the biggest difference, as evidenced in this video, is actually using technology. I know in my generation, we had to, in class, we had to share computers for high school. So we had one computer for every 10 students. And so understanding how to operate a computer was so much more of how to get a job. It wasn't a way of living. Now today, all kids, all younger folks, I should say, they walk around with, you know, powerful smartphones that have more power in them than the big computers we had growing up. So I think technology is the one thing.
Can you tell me about a major event, historical or social, that you can that you remember from your youth?
Well, the event that comes to me most is when John F. Kennedy was assassinated in Dallas. That was probably in sixth grade, and it stuck with me as fresh as a bell. You'd see it on TV. They closed the schools, and I just thought it was a tragic event because I thought he was a great president.
Okay, and what is the major difference between your generation and the generation that became before you?
I would just definitely say technology. It's just changed how my entire generation communicates, and just kind of the major differences between even two generations ago, like the Gen Xers and the Millennials, as they're calling us now, is technology and growing up with that technology.
Yeah. Okay, can you tell me a major event that you remember during your lifetime?
The fighting for equal rights for gays. I'm a gay man, and it was a long time coming, and my generation is the ones that made it possible.
Yeah.
And I'll always remember that. That's something that is happened in my lifetime that is very historical to me.
Okay, what do you think is the major difference between your generation and generations before yours?
I think the major difference is the values of our generation. I feel like they've completely changed, as well as music. It's hard to find good music. All the good music has already been made.
And the other thing is it's all about getting stuff easy nowadays, and older generations about hard work, getting things done like that, and now it's just about getting rich fast.
My question to you is, what would you consider to be the biggest difference between your generation and today's generation, the youth today?
For me, I think the biggest difference in the generation is, I think the younger generation has a greater ability to express themselves. You know, they have pink hair, piercings, tattoos. My generation, I think, was a little more conservative. You know, there was right and wrong, and it doesn't seem like there's so much of that anymore. It's all good.
Uh-huh. And how do you feel, sir?
You know, I grew up with long hair, and, you know, it was all the hippie scene kind of thing. and I see it here, but it's, you know, everyone's still expressing themselves, you know, and I like that. You know, I get along with it. I agree with it, and I like the kids that are here today, and they do what they want. You know, it's not a bad thing.